Hi there, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie and it's great to have you here. Today I want to have some fun with Adobe Firefly. Recently, they made some upgrades to the generative AI and you can produce some really fantastic images just by typing in a short text. And I really like the way they have everything set up that you can make aspect ratio changes on the image. But not only can you do that, you can do generative fill, which is a fun tool to take things out of images, add things to images, or even make some really fancy text that you can download also. And the great thing about all this, we can start this by just doing this for free by making an Adobe account. That's what I want to show you how to do today on Teachers Tech. So I'll put the link to this page down below in the description so you can get right here. As I mentioned, you can sign up for free, or if you already have an Adobe account, you can just sign in with that. Just go to the top right-hand corner and click sign in, and you'll get prompted. If you don't have an account, you can go ahead and create a new account and sign in with what you want to. So I'm going to be demoing with the free account today. So go ahead and get your account and follow along. So I'm all logged into my account. If you do want to upgrade at any time from the free one, you can just click on the upgrade and see the different price options. With the free one, you get 25 monthly generative credits there. I just wanted to point that out. So it's not unlimited when you're creating all these fantastic images. Now, the things I want to kind of walk through are these three things today, right here, are the text to image, generative fill, and text effects. I could start from right here by typing something in and hit generate, but I'm just going to go ahead and click generate here and we'll start with text to image. Now, as you scroll through, you're going to see all these amazing examples that are already created. And the nice thing with this, you can hover over these to see what they had to write to create the image. Now, I could go ahead and just start by typing a prompt in here of whatever I want and then hit generate. But I'm going to choose this one to begin with just as a sample here. So I'm going to click on it and you can see right away kind of what they were given. So with this prompt that they wrote here, they were given this. And take a look at the few different options. So we have the model version. So this is kind of the new updated one, the 2. If we click on this, we can go to the Firefly image 1, but I'm going to keep it into number 2. You can see generate high quality images of people, improve text alignment. So I'm going to stay with this one. This is what I really like about using this. So I can change the aspect ratio quickly. So if I wanted it a 4:3, 3:4, 1:1, or widescreen, I can go ahead and choose that. We can go from a photo to art just by simply clicking on it. We have our strength of style, which we can change. The other thing is we can upload our own image to match the style from an image so that it can, if you had a certain image with a look, we can do that. And then all the effects. So again, this just makes it so easy to play with all these. Let's start with trying to change this. So instead of the dog being here, let's say amazing photograph of a, well, we're just going to say cat and see what happens. So I'm going to change that to cat. And I'm just going to generate here and I'm going to see what happens from it. So if you don't know where to start from, take a look at what other people have created and then go from that point. So it didn't take very long at all. Now I have the cat chasing the tennis ball underneath. Now I could get specific with the type of cat that I wanted. Maybe I don't want it to be a tennis ball. So if I say baseball on this, let's see how quickly this can change and I'll generate this. So now I have my cat chasing the baseball and it's sticking to a kind of a photograph. It looks realistic on it, but I could keep going through and changing these. Now, if you find one that you do like, if I go ahead and click on it, you can see the different options that I could switch from. But if you like it, you can go and heart it so that you save to your favorites. But you have some other options. I'm going to talk about these generative fill and when we go on out of this text image one, but I want to show you, you have some more options here as well. So if I click on this, I can download this. I can copy the link. I can copy image. I can edit in Adobe Express. I have a different tutorial in Adobe Express. That's a great program. if I want to download it, I can just hit download. I am using the free one. It shows you that this content credentials will be applied to let people know it was generated with AI. And I'm just going to go ahead and hit continue. It downloads it quickly. If I go and just click and open this one up, it should pop open. I'm just going to bring it. So here is my image, and this was the watermark that Adobe Firefly put on it. I am using the free one, so I just want to point out you do have that. So this is all part of the free one that I'm using right now. And remember, you can start from scratch. So if I go back, just hit back up here, try typing anything right in here to get what you want. So a lot of times my last one when I was showing about Bing, I typed in a bunny playing a flaming saxophone. So I'm just going to go ahead and write this and see what we get, and see, then I can compare it with my other ones that I was going to use this as a base to, just to see what gets created. And notice I have this on art right now. If I go ahead to go to photo, and I'm going to go ahead and generate this again, and we'll see the changes that we get. So now I'm getting a little bit more photos in this. If I take a look at this, I can go through and kind of just, this one has the playing backwards, so you can see there are, it's not going to be perfect, but as you go through and start to get your prompts more accurate, go find your styles down here and the effects to apply on any of these, and then just start having some fun with it. So that is the text to image in Firefly. You can go back, it will bring you to the main page. I can go back again. We're back at this page. Now I want to show you how to use the generative fill. This generative fill is so much fun to play with. One of my favorite things right now is such a game changer. I'm just going to go ahead and hit generate here. Adobe Photoshop also has this built into it, and it just changes when you're making modification to images. And as it gets better, it's just going to be used so much. Now I can upload an image, which I'm going to do in a moment. I'm going to go and show you, you can click on any of these samples here. So if I click on it, and you can start playing around with these images here, so you don't have to upload an image, and all the things I'm about to show you are right through here. So I'm just going to go back a step. I have this image right here on my desktop. I'm going to just drag it over. I could click upload, and we're going to make some changes to this image. We're going to add something to it, and we're going to delete. And I'm going to show you how easy this works. So I'm just zooming up on my mouse here. I have on the side, we have insert, remove, and pan. Pan just allows me to move the image around. Insert allows me to put something new. In this case, what do I want new? Well, I want sunglasses on him. Notice how big my brush is there. I'm going to change the settings here. I'm going to click and bring my brush size down just to about here should do it. Notice I can also make changes in these two items as well, but I'm not for this example. So where do I want the sunglasses to be? Well, it's going to be right through there. So even though it looks like I'm erasing something, this is where the generative fill will fill in the sunglasses to match around that hole. So if I say, what do I want in there? I'll keep this really easy. If I just type sunglasses like this and hit generate, it will take a moment, but you'll see the sunglasses pop up and it will give me three different choices to choose from. So now I have sunglasses on. I can choose which one I want. I could go cancel, try to type something else if they don't match the way you want. Sometimes it takes a while, maybe changing your prompt to get it better, to getting it to match to this specific spot that you want. And you can click more. Sometimes I believe that might be an upgrade to get more of these. So in this one, I'm just going to leave it at this first one right here. So I'll hit keep. That's how easy you can add something in. I'll come back and add something in a moment. I want to show you how you can remove something very easy. Let's say this computer and this sandwich, I don't want it there. If I go to remove, all I have to do is mark the area that I want removed like this. And now I can click remove. And just watch how this fills this in. Notice that the vest and everything, that computer is gone. The hand right here looks a little bit messed up. Try a few of the other ones. Ooh, that one looks a little bit more Not too bad, actually. It's not perfect a lot of time, but it gives you an idea. Notice how the jacket changes each time to kind of fill in that spot too as well. And the coffee cup looks a little smushed on the bottom. So again, you can play with different ones. You can try to see what works the best. I'm just gonna leave it as this one. So maybe I want the dog gone, or maybe I want something added to it. I can go back to insert. Maybe I want a cat right beside. So I'm just gonna make a brush larger here, and I'm gonna just mark this right here. And we're gonna write cat. Again, I could get more specific with my prompts, but just to demo, to show you how this works, I'm just trying to show you how quickly. So we have a sample of a cat. Not sure what the cat is doing. When we can keep and working, or we can cancel if we don't get anything that we like on it. I'm going to hit cancel. I want to show you also we have our background remover, or we have invert. So if we go to background, you're going to see that the whole background disappears on it. I meant to put this back so the dog doesn't have legs right now. But what do I want to generate? Let's say if I type forest and generate, it will place this person in the forest in the background here. So I can simply change around where the person is too. So go and try some of these fun things. Notice we do have our download and share at the end, but try the different ones to see how everything works. Pointing out the legs got filled in. Even though they were erased, they're not perfect. They got filled in to match the picture here. I'm not sure that doesn't even look like a dog anymore, but it changed the angle that the dog was looking and everything. Go have some fun with Generative Fill. The last one I want to show you today is text effects in Adobe Firefly. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit generate. This works very similar to the other ones that from the text to image, but this time it's going to create a text with a design for us. So as I hover over any of these, if I hover over this, it's pizza, and it gives me the samples that I can show you that I've showed you before when you were just using image to text. Now, how do we generate? Well, let's go and give it a sample text and we'll just say hello. And what do I want it to be like? Let's say I want white tiger. And I'm going to go and generate. There's the hello text. I can kind of see what it's going to fill in. So it's going to take my prompt and fill it in. I can go and choose different ones, these samples that it gives here. As it fills it in, it just takes that moment, like always. I have, if I look over to the right here, we have some samples that we can go from. I'm going to go and match the shape. I'm going to choose tight. Let's go pick a different font. I'll pick this right here. And maybe I don't want a transparent background. I want a color. So I'll just pick this orange and I'm going to hit generate. And this will be generated based on all those things that I just picked. So there it is. And I can do my different samples again. If I like what I get, I can go ahead, send it to my favorites, or I can go to more options, download this, copy the image, just like those ones I showed you before, and then you can go and use it from there. So I hope you kind of like this walkthrough today of Adobe Firefly. I have a lot of fun playing with this. I'm using the free version to show you. I do have a different account where I do have a paid for one, so I get more credits that way. Test it out. Let me know what you think. Photoshop does have these features built into it. I'll come out with a different tutorial showing that as well. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.